Ultra allows you to organize your content in two main ways, using modules and folders. Let's take a look at some of the differences between the two and why you might choose one over the other. The first difference is visual. You'll see folders have an icon of a file folder next to them, and you're not really able to customize it much further than that. When using a module, there's not a default icon, but you can add your own custom image if you like. Both allow for a title and description that's visible without opening it. And when you click to open either a folder or a module, you'll see the contents inside will drop down. And they can contain any of the types of content that you can create in the course content menu. While folders are designed to group documents or related information together in a single container, modules add the possibility for organizing the material into a sequence. Once the content is ordered in a module, instructors can choose whether to allow students to complete that content in any order or to force a sequence by going into the edit menu and selecting forced sequence. That requires that students complete each item before gaining access to the next. Navigating between the content within a module or folder for a student is slightly different. Clicking an item in a folder opens that content in a new navigation layer. To view another item in the folder, the user must close it and click to choose the next item, which opens in its own layer, or in the case of a link, it opens in a new window. If you're in a module, you can click the module contents, which opens in a new layer, but you'll see there is an option to select the link to the next item. So the student can click directly into the next item, which might be a document to read, or it may bring you directly to a discussion or some other type of content like a quiz or assignment. You'll notice in Ultra that you can now only create two levels of folders. This keeps students from getting lost in a maze of folders here. So when I go into the create within a second folder, you'll see it isn't an option to create another folder within that. It's also important to notice that you can add folders to modules, but modules cannot be placed inside of a folder or within another module. So if you're using modules, they are the top level of navigation that a student will encounter. If you're using a course that has a big asynchronous aspect to it, where students need to be able to manage their way through the content on their own, modules might make a lot of sense. Whereas if you are teaching a course that they just need to access the content at their own pace and need it well organized, folders might make sense. It just depends on what's right for your students and your course. We hope this has been a helpful introduction to some of Blackboard Ultra's tools. If you're an instructor who needs support in Ultra, contact UAA's instructional design team at UAA_design@alaska.edu. If you're a student who needs support in Ultra, contact the UAA Technical Support Center by calling 907-786-4646 or emailing uaa.techsupport@alaska.edu.